I'm Mike Kensler with the Auburn University Office of Sustainability, and I'm here to tell you about the Sustainability Compass. We love this compass because it's a very simple visual image of what sustainability is all about, the four system conditions of a sustainable world. The compass was created by Alan Atkison in 1997 at a meeting of the Balaton Group. Alan and his colleagues were exploring indicators of sustainability, and they were looking at Herman Daly's triangle. At the base, nature itself was the ultimate means for all human endeavor. For intermediate means, he identified the economy. Intermediate ends, society, a healthy society. The ultimate ends of all human endeavor is individual well-being. Well, as the group talked about the triangle as a way to describe the indicators, they couldn't come to agreement. For one thing, it was linear. For another, there were some folks who thought the ultimate ends is society, not individuals, and how do we trade those off? It just wasn't working, and somebody said, you know, it's just not a good compass for us. Well, that's when the idea popped into Alan's head. He noticed that in English, anyway, the four cardinal points of the compass, north, east, south, and west, start with the same letters as the four indicators of sustainability that Herman Daly had developed: nature, economy, society, and well-being. So he went to the whiteboard, drew a compass, and drew Daly's words in at each of the four cardinal points. And this is a picture of Alan Atkison at the moment of creation in 1997. The four system conditions of sustainability. We'll start with nature. The bottom line is humanity has to learn how to live in accord with the laws and limits of the natural world. Why? Nature creates conditions for life to thrive. If you think about it, for more than 3 billion years, nature's been creating ever more complex, diverse, abundant, interdependent, resilient, and beautiful life. So to create a sustainable world, humanity must learn to understand, appreciate, and respect the laws of nature, the laws of life itself. Next is the economy. We need a robust, viable, productive economy that is fair and inclusive. It meets the needs of all, not just some at the expense of the rest, and an economy that learns how to operate in accord with the laws and limits of nature. Companies like Interface, Patagonia, Ben & Jerry's, and their parent company Unilever are all committed to achieving this. If you'd like to know what a 21st century economy could look like, I highly recommend Donut Economics by Oxford economist Kate Raworth. Society. Collective well-being. This is about, at every scale of community, good schools, a robust and inclusive local business community, diverse and welcoming faith community, safe neighborhoods and decent housing for everyone, clean air, clean water, political voice, justice, equity, diversity and inclusion for all, a sense of civic pride and identity, a commitment to the common good, and finally, individual well-being. This is about fulfillment, about quality of life, about mental, emotional, physical, and spiritual health, meaningful relationships. So there you have it, the four system conditions of a sustainable world. The compass makes it easy for us to remember what they are, and it helps us evaluate our individual and collective impacts on each other and the world around us. And it truly does serve as a compass to help us create what Kate Raworth describes as a safe and just place for all of humanity within the means of our life-giving planet.